Hello, my name is Jeff Estes. I'm the Director of Partners of THINC with Okuma America. Today, we got a request to run a very hot job in the middle of a production run we have out on our field. We're not in trouble. There's capabilities to do this very quickly and to change it over. Let's go through some of those basic steps. We need a program, whether it comes on a memory stick or we pull it down from the ether by Ethernet in from the server. We need to get it into our machine. With the Okuma's OSP control, it's very simple because it's very easy to connect via Ethernet as a PC control, or it will run off this USB port. Now we've got our program in our machine. You can see my tool list. These are the tools that are in the machine. I've already reviewed my program from my job sheet, the tools that I need. Everything looks good. Let's verify. I'm going to go to the ATC. I'm just going to verify that those tools are there. Electronic and now visual verification. Good. If not, I would make sure that electronic and visual verification was there and I had the right tools in and I'd get the right tooling information loaded in to the tool data so I wouldn't crash this part. So now, simply need a fixture and a part. We happen to have a Schunk Veros quick change system on here which allows us to go from one fixture to another very quickly and to repeat that position to within 5 microns or 2/10,000ths of an inch. It is pneumatically operated. It is held in place by springs and pneumatically operated to disengage those springs. My current job is now off. I want to make sure that my work surface is clean. My new job is on. I'm going to plug that pneumatic line simply with a plug ring. Now we have repeated one fixture to another to within 5 microns or 2/10,000ths of an inch. At this point is simply use the probing system to find my final work offset. Let that correct itself here. Now I'm ready to run that part. Those are the steps that you go through for a changeover. You can honestly do this changeover in 10 to 15 minutes very easily if you've done your planning up front and you've got the right systems in place to allow you to work that hot job in. Once you're done with this one, it's simply reverse the process, go back to your job that you were running, and keep that production flow. Hope this helps.